bad, man. They're doing that a lot of states, though. But you know what? They're beating their head against the wall. Because the homeless people are here to stay, man. And they ain't going nowhere. In fact, they're getting bigger exponentially every year. They can't tell me. I don't care how, man, I've seen it. And it's more than doubled in Portland. Portland has just gotten insane. I was there last year, and I mean, it was bad then. But now, it's more than twice as bad. It was hard for me to even sit down anywhere and feel safe sleeping. Anywhere in that whole fucking town. In Portland, I loved it when I first went there, but now, you know, they got that ordinance where the homeless can sleep anywhere on the walk and shit, you know. So, tent cities. But everywhere, it's, I don't know if it's the meth that's making all the cities bad, but whatever is producing the homeless people, they're coming in droves everywhere. Whole families, you know, I run into whole families out here. Yeah. Not so much here, but the cities, but they're moving this way though. You can believe they're gonna branch out because they ain't got no choice. Attitude. People tired of the bureaucracy, all the red tape bullshit. Every fucking thing you gotta do to just to get pay a $20 bill, you gotta, you know, you get 10, or, you know, go to the doctor, oh my God. Get one prescription, you got like that, a stack of paperwork, you know, take home with you. You know, it's ridiculous. It's all information gathering and money. It's all about money. They take your information, sell it, you know, and then they resell it. Your information's all over. But it don't matter. Shit, they can tell how many times they shit if they want to do. I see little gyrocopters around. You know, not so much here, but big cities, they got them flying around. He can bring them down with laser pointers and shit. And not do it. You know what? How I remind myself of? Actually, look, there's a movie called Runaway Train. You ever seen it?
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Boy.
Yeah, it's good. it's really,
really
good.
Good movie. Won Academy Award for it. Yeah, one of the best prison break movies I've ever seen. Whoever wrote the dialogue for that movie had to be in prison. But there's a poem at the end of that. And in fact, I was going to put it on my thing. I got a Shakespeare poem on the front of it right now. But a lot of people, they use it in the Willy Wonka movie. At the end, you see Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory?
Oh,
Gene Wilder?
Yeah.
The original? Jeez. At the end, when the kid gave the everlasting gobstopper back to him, Gene Wilder said, "His soul shines a good deed in a weary world." You know, it's a Shakespeare quote, and he gave him the Chocolate Factory. You know, but he returned the candy to, because he was punished, you know.
What would you like
to change? The world needs to be humbled, though. You can put it in a nutshell. The whole world needs to be humbled. City by city, or town by town, or the whole world at one time. That would be better, but that ain't gonna happen. But town by town, it'd be possible. Oh, yeah. People too caught up in their life, man. It's too much shit. Sweden had a better approach to it. They focused more on the family orientation than anything else. They're the only country that does that. I mean, like their company, you know, Japan, they focus on the company first. You know, Sweden is, they focus on the family. And they give you a lot of time off. I mean, that your hours are, they got a lot, it's different over there because of that. North what?
Like that bureaucracy and greed. And...
Well, I never liked it. I was always a square peg trying to fit in the round hole anyway. But being out, and I ran into more and more people that prefer to be out and just free to do, man, the stress just kills you, man. I had triple bypass heart surgery in 2012. I don't take no medicine. All I do is smoke weed, occasional beer. And 2012, bro. And I'm 55, and sometimes I put 180 pounds on my back in the backpack. Well, you've seen the low light, Jerry.
Yeah.
I got this because I get cans and stuff. And it helps a lot. And while I'm here, and I'll leave to somebody when I leave, like I did last time. I had one just like it last year. I left to a girl. I take what I want off it, just. But I like to be mobile, and it's better. People are selling everything, liquidating their houses and everything, and getting them. In fact, I just recently, when I was in San Jose several months ago, actually, I befriended a guy that worked at the Starbucks up there, and I met him in the parking lot skateboarding at 3 o'clock in the morning. He was a manager, a tall, redhead guy. He looked like a Shaggy off of Scooby-Doo, but we got high, you know, and being friends. And over a period of time, he was the more and more talking to him. And I ran into him, a couple months, we got separated. A couple months later, and he did it. He sold him and his old lady, sold everything, and he got a van. And I ran into him in San Jose, and he brought that was in Santa Clara where he worked at. Yep, they're going on the road. They're going to live out, you know, and travel and see the world and fuck all the red tape. The only thing you got to focus on is your van. That's it. Nothing else. So, nothing. You know, insurance and that, you know, keep the upkeep of the van. Yeah. Well, there's too much clutter. Too much clutter. People too focused on, you know, the material thing. Of course, that's nature. But, and man, we're all our own worst enemy, you know. But then again, one redeeming quality, yeah, I believe we have, but our very best things are their very worst. That's my quote. I think that's true. People can be very resourceful if they have to be, and humble. They don't care. I mean, they're focused on their life, their way of life, and trying to keep up with the Joneses. That's, you know. If they're not doing it, we're not going to do it, you know. The masses have been proven to be wrong time and time again, but yet people, you know, go along with the crowds, you know, because they're scared. I was one of them. Was.
Do you regret any decisions you made?
Huh?
Do you regret any of your decisions?
No. I can go back. I got home. I got friends and family up in Illinois that want me to come back right now. I was going to go up there for a visit recently, but I couldn't put the money together all at one time to get the ticket and all that. I don't want at some point. I got to go see mom. You know, I got sisters. All my family's up there. And we're all still close. I communicate with them on Facebook.
Where do you call home?
Freeport, Illinois. You know anybody up there in Illinois?
That actually works.
Hey. Oh, that's scary. There you go.
So how has Seaside treated you?
Seaside?
Yeah.
Seaside, there's magic here, bro.
Oh, yeah?
Oh, yeah, there's magic Seaside. I call it Willy Wonka Wheel.
How do you describe it?
I don't know. There's a negative element, too. There's a bad seed in here, you know, but it's not as bad. Seaside and Astoria have shown the only signs of improvement in the last year since I've been up here. And all the other states I've been to, and everywhere, they've all got worse. This Seaside and Astoria has shown signs of improvement. As far as drugs and the homeless situation. Well, there's not as much of the drug activity around anymore as there was. There were drug tweakers. And you can sleep more peaceful up here. The cops are real tolerant. As long as you don't fuck around and trash the place and all that goofy shit. You know? And I caught the guy who was trashing the bathrooms and leaving all the trash can doors open and busting all the locks off the plug-ins and shit all over town. I finally caught up with who it was, but I'm gonna deal with him. He's got a couple animals with him, so for their sake.